Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org. Quite often, JPQL is not powerful enough to perform the queries you need in real-world projects. In general, this is not an issue because JPA is designed as a leaky abstraction, and you can use the full potential of SQL by using native queries. The only downside is that these queries return a list of object arrays instead of the mapped entities and value objects you are used to get from JPQL queries. You can see an example of a native query and the result handling here on the slide. Each object array in the list contains one record returned by the database. You then need to iterate through the array, cast each object to its specific type, and map them to your domain model. This creates lots of repetitive code and typecast. It would be more comfortable if you could tell the entity manager to map the result of the query into entities or value objects, as it is the case for JPQL statements. The good news is JPA provides this functionality. It is called SQL Reside Set Mapping, and in this video, I will show you how to use it to map your query results to managed entities. The easiest way to map a query result to an entity is to provide the entity class as a parameter to the createNativeQuery method of the entity manager and use the default mapping. The code snippet here on the slide shows an example of it with a simple query. In a real project, you would use this with a stored procedure or a very complex SQL query. The query needs to return all properties of the entity, and the JPA implementation will try to map the return columns to the entity properties based on their name and type. If that is successful, the entity manager will return a list of fully initialized author entities that are managed by the current persistence context. So the result is the same as if you had used a JPQL query, but you're not limited to the small feature set of JPQL. Let's jump into the IDE and give this a try before I show you how to define a custom mapping. Here you can see the same query as I showed you on the slide. It selects all columns mapped by the author entity, and I provide the author class as the second parameter to the createNativeQuery method. Let's run this test and see what happens. Here you can see the same SQL query as I provided to the createNativeQuery method. The mapping of the query result has no impact on the query itself. Hibernate executed the query as I defined it and used the mapping information afterwards to handle the result. While this automatic mapping is useful and easy to specify, it is often not sufficient. If you perform a more complex query or call a stored procedure, the names of the returned columns might not match the entity definition. In these cases, you need to define a custom result mapping that needs to specify the mapping for all entity properties, even if the default mapping cannot be applied to only one property. You can define a custom mapping with the SQL Reside Set Mapping annotation. You can see an example here on the slide. The mapping consists of a name and an entity result annotation, which defines the mapping of the entity. Let's have a more detailed look at it in the IDE. Here you can see the same SQL result set mapping as I showed you on the slide. It consists of a name and an entity result definition. I will use the name of the mapping later to tell the entity manager which mapping it shall use. The entity result annotation defines the entity class to which the result shall be mapped, and an array of field result annotations which define the mapping between the column name and the entity property. Okay, so now we have defined a custom mapping between the query result and the author entity. As you can see here, you can now provide the name of the mapping instead of the entity class as a parameter to the createNativeQuery method. Hibernate will then use the mapping defined by the SQL ResideSet mapping annotation to map the query result to managed author entities. You can see the SQL query here. As in the previous example, the result mapping had no effect on the query. Hibernate executes the query and applies the mapping afterwards. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video, and an ebook about native queries, which provides a lot more details about SQL result set mappings. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!